It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the dark. Try as I may, I could never explain what I hear when you don't say a thing. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. A touch of your hand says you'll catch me if ever I fall. Say nothing at all. All day long I can hear people talking out loud. But when you hold me near, you drown out the crowd. Oh, Mr. Webster could never define what's being said between your heart and mine. The smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying of your head says you'll catch me if ever I fall. Yeah, you say it best when you say nothing. When you say nothing at all.
We have gathered here this afternoon in the sight of God and in the presence of family and friends to unite together in holy matrimony Trace Aaron Rayner and Aaron Marie Shaw. Marriage is an institution created by God and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or carelessly, but reverently, joyfully, and in the love of God. Trace and Aaron have come today desiring to be united in this sacred relationship. If anyone can show just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let them speak now or forever hold their peace. Who gives this bride to this groom in marriage?
Her mother and I.
You may be seated. Good that man should be alone, I will make him a helper comparable to him. And the Lord God caused the deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept, and he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in its place. Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman, and he brought her to the man. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." God is the one who created marriage and instituted the family. God loved us and created us to love each other and to love others. Our lives find completion only as we love and are loved in return. Together we can become what we could never be separately. Love is a gift.
So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For there is no one ever who hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it just as the Lord does the church. We are members of his body, all of his flesh and all his bones. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh, which is why we're gathered here today. Scripture says this is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let each one of you in particular so love his own wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. God's word is given to us, inspiration and encouragement, challenges us to that love, a love for each other. Even as the two has become one, Trace, you are charged with being the leader of the home, not just physically and emotionally, but also spiritually. As you seek to live in unity with Christ, as he is the head of the church, so will the desire of unity grow within your marriage. Trace and Aaron, marriage can be such a beautiful thing. But it must be entered into with the understanding of the commitment you make to each other today before Christ. As you both seek to grow in your relationship with Christ, so will your marriage grow and become all God ordained from the very beginning. I also want to share with you this afternoon from another of Paul's writings in Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 and 3. I therefore, prisoner of the Lord, urge you to walk in a manner worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, eager to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. Challenge to you both this day forward. This emotion of love is special and is to be enjoyed as God is love, but also is the commitment to cherish and grow your love for each other today and always. Let us pray. Father, who gives us all of our precious and wonderful gifts, thank you for the gift of marriage. I thank you today for Trace and Aaron and the love relationship that has developed between them. It is my prayer that their relationship would grow and mature with each passing day. that the home they establish today will be one of spiritual strength and steadfast obedience, your perfect will in their lives. We pray the Holy Spirit will guide and nurture their relationship now and for always. In Jesus' name. Trace, I'm going to ask you to repeat after me. Okay? I, Trace, thank you, Aaron, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. To you I pledge my love. Aaron, if you will repeat. I, Aaron, take you, Trace, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. To you I pledge my love. Now I hope someone here has dreams. These rings which you give to each other as your sign of love, devotion, everlasting peace. Amen. Repeat after me. Okay. This ring is my sacred gift to you. A symbol of my love, a sign that from this day forward and always my love will surround you. With this ring I thee wed. Sacred gift to you, a symbol of my love, a sign that from this day forward and always my love will surround you. With this ring I thee wed. Today, Trace and Aaron have chosen to braid 3 strands together into a single cord. Each strand has a significant meaning. 1 strand represents God, who has given the gift of love. The 2nd strand represents the groom and his life. The 3rd strand represents the bride and her life. In braiding these 3 strands together, Trace and Aaron are demonstrating that their marriage is more than a joining of 2 lives together. It is a unity with God as well. They have chosen to allow God to be at the center of their marriage, woven into every aspect of it. By keeping Him at the center of your marriage, His love will continue to bind you together as one throughout your marriage. As Ecclesiastes 4:9-12 reads, two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, one will lift up his companion. But woe to him who is alone when he falls, for he has no one to help him up. Again, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one be warm alone? But one may be overpowered by another, two can withstand him, and a three-fold cord is not quickly broken. You have symbolized your love, putting these strands together, braiding them together with God at the center of this marriage. Let's pray. O eternal God, creator and preserver, giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send thy blessings upon this man and this woman who be blessed in thy name. They, living faithfully together, may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant between them, as symbolized by these rings, as a token and a pledge, and may ever remain in perfect love and peace together and live according to thy laws. Amen. Inasmuch as both Trace and Eric have come together in the presence of God and this company of witnesses, pledging their commitment to each other in marriage by the exchanging of rings, I, by the power vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, do hereby pronounce them as husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one but asunder. Trace, you may kiss your wife. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Trace Reiner.
once again, everybody. Can everyone hear me okay? Hey, everybody in the back, y'all hear me all right? All right, so we want to sincerely thank everyone for coming out and joining with us this evening and celebrating the joining of your two families. Both of your family trees now have a lot of new branches, and may they always continue to do so. Now, we have a wonderful evening planned for you. We've already got some good food, a little bit of drink. If not, please step to the back or outside and ask the bartender to help you out. But before we can get the rest of the evening going, we do have some very special guests that we need to announce, the reason we are all here tonight. So if everyone could please face toward the door for our bridal party's grand entrance. And they're ready to get started, so we're gonna move through fairly quickly. Are you ready? All right, up first, please, big round of applause for Brian escorting Brooke. Then next, we have TJ, Katie, and Luke. That's right, you got a man in the jar. All right, up next, we have Hannah coming in with Austin. And let's keep it going for Clayton, walking in with Kayla. And next we have Nick coming in with Nicole. Then we have Isaac coming in with his tall sweetheart, Mary Lee. One more big round for Corey escorting Haley. Get a big standing up for our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. TraceFinal. To the stage. Let's keep it there because now we have the bride and groom's first dance. It's husband and wife.
It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the dark.
And if we can have our lovely bride stay on the floor for just a moment. And where is the father of the bride? It's time for him to dance with his baby girl.
First steps, first words, seems like yesterday we were just a girl. Skin knees, climbing trees, all those memories so close to me.
Trace, it's your turn, sir. You can step back to the floor, and where's your beautiful mother?
She knows. her place. She holds on as long as she can to her little man. She held that baby so tight in her arms. One day she blinked, he was grown. Those first steps together, they filled up her heart as he heads off to his senior prom. She says, how about a dance with mom? And she dances with her little man, spinning around, hand in hand, cause she knows that there'll come a day when some lucky girl will dance in her place. She holds on as long as she can to her little man.
Okay, and before we get to dinner, we do have one other special dance, actually. So we are going to hear from our band now. They have a special one that's going out from Trace to his new wife.
Trace, congratulations, y'all. Thank you so much for having us with us, with you all here. I'm so glad to be here.
All right, guys, we're going to have let somebody know and say a few words to the bride and groom. So I'm giving this to you. And now it's time for our entertainment portion of the evening. Could we please get all of the single ladies to the dance floor? If you don't have a ring on your finger, if you are not currently betrothed, please make your way to the dance floor, ladies.
Where are you at? I need all of my gentlemen that are currently unmarried to make their way to the floor, please. Don't be scared, guys. Where's my single fellas at? Fellas! Come on, single fellas, where you guys at now? There we go.
Say what? Single means not married.
Come on, guys, if you are not married, you do not have a ring on your finger, just like the women. Please make your way to the front.
Damn, look, this young buck had to be dragged up here. All
right, fellas, you ready? Get ready, guys. Trace, are you ready? All right, fellas. Three. There we go. Good morning. Finally heard us. All right, Trace. Three, two, one. Launch it.
Each time he's been as depressing, let's see that took her out. We got up in bed, I said to myself, oh, what am I this to be? It was love. I sent her some wine-colored roses, the color of all of mine. And she said, the wine-colored roses, if I was the wine-colored roses, they'll tell her I'm still on the wine. When she said the wine-colored
give me the word of surprise. All that silver I need is hot down soft. See no summer sun blue helps me remember you. I don't wanna get over you. I don't wanna get over.
Hills that surround me,
a place I could use, a place I could lose. The Tennessee blue. You're the one who made me say good luck and be. Somebody's doing me right, somebody's holding me tight, making my days and my nights somebody I really like. Just the touch of your hand, you make me feel like a man. There's been a change in my life, somebody's doing me right. It's alright. It's alright. Somebody's doing me right. Somebody's pulling me tight, making my days and my nights. Somebody I really like. Just the touch of her hand, she makes me feel like a man. There's been a change in my life, somebody's doing me right. It's alright. It's alright. It's alright.
Thank you.
If I had regret, I got promise her long ago. The words wouldn't come when I call and she answered. Oh, but I found a way to say no. I sent her some wine-colored roses, the color on the vine. And she said the wine-colored
here, painted on the side.
whole life too, for I